with a long listing. So we saw list command, ls command, and pwd command. We'll see cd command. So I'll create some. Before that, we'll create some directory. I'll say mkdir. I'll say India. Okay. We'll say first mkdir Asia. Okay. We'll do a cd command to change my directory to. I say as Asia. I'll do as and type tab, so it automatically completes the folder name. I'll say make directory India. I'll again say cd I and I'll say tab, so it completes the command for me, completes the directory name. Now I'm in you can see if I say pwd, it will say I'm in /home/mac/asia/india. I can do a make directory command again, mkdir. I can say Karnataka. I can say cd Karnataka, ka and tab. So I don't have to type complete word. So this is the specialty of Linux command terminal. So I can use, if I see print working directory shows /home/asia/india/karnataka. So I can create one more directory, mkdir Bangalore. I can say cd Bangalore, so change directory to Bangalore. I can say make directory Yelahanka. So I'll to go back one directory, I'll say pwd. It prints the working directory. I can say I can go one directory back pressing dot dot. Cd dot dot means the meaning of dot dot is the previous directory. So now we are in Bangalore directory. We'll go to Karnataka directory. You can see it shows Karnataka here. So the last directory. Again, if I do cd dot dot, it goes to India directory. If I do cd dot, it goes to Asia directory. If I do cd dot dot, it goes to my home directory. That is slash. You can see what is the home directory? /home/mac. So I'll go to Asia again. I'll go to Asia folder again. Cd India. Okay. So pwd, you can see I created. Now if I create one more directory, I'll list here. I'll do ls here. You can see there's Karnataka. If I do one more, mkdir. I'll do Delhi, cd Delhi. I can do mkdir. I can type Birla Mandir. I'll write Birla inside Delhi. So now if I want to go to, I'll say pwd. So it's /home/mac/asia/india/delhi. So if I want to, I can go to Birla folder now. So if I want to go to directly the Bangalore folder, I can say cd /home/mac/asia/india/karnataka/bangalore. I can go this way. Okay. So now, if I want to go back to Birla, I can say cd -, so previous directory. Okay, this was the directory which was even early. It was not the one directory above. So if I want to go to Bangalore directory again, I can say cd --. So that we have gone to Delhi directory now. Dot dot takes to Delhi directory, and dot dot again takes to India directory. And I can say /ka Karnataka. I can type tab. I can say Bangalore, and I. See, now we go to Bangalore directory. This way we can use a relative path, that is going two directories back, that is cd --. So now we are in Karnataka directory. When I do dot dot, it goes to Karnataka directory. I do dot dot, it goes to India directory. I say Delhi Birla. You can see, so I can change the directory like this using a relative path, or I can give absolute path. I can say cd /home/mac/asia/india/delhi Okay, it's already in Delhi directory. You can see Karnataka, Bangalore. So this way I can use the complete path and change the path. So these are like we can use either a relative path or absolute path to change my directory from one is to other. So command completion is, if I want to type some command, mkdir, if I say tab, I get options how can I complete the command. So r, so I can do like this. I can also say passw, you say dab, you see it automatically completes the command for me. See if it has a dilemma, it gives an option to you. You can use password command. You can also use cd ... You can see I press only D. If there is no dilemma, it directly gives Delhi, and if I say tab again, it gives Birla. So this way the command completion takes place automatically here. So cd ... gives the previous directory. Cd dot is the same directory, it will not change the directory. Dot is the current directory and ... is the previous directory. I can move files. For example, I'll go to cd/home/mac/asia/india/karnataka/bangalore. Okay, I'll create a file here. I can use touch command, touch file 1. Okay, we created file 1 in the folder pwdld. In this folder we created a file file 1 using touch command. So if I want to copy this file, I can kcp file. I can say going one folder behind, again one folder behind, Delhi Birla. So if I copy there, you can see ls here, also one file is there. Okay, in Bangalore directory. If I say ls/home/mac/asia/india/Delhi/Birla, you can see there also one file is there. So two copies of file is there. So if I say move, I mean currently I'm in Bangalore directory, I say mv file to ... that is current directory. After that current directory we have a Bangalore directory, sorry, Yelahanka directory, because we already in so I can move the file from Bangalore directory to Yelahanka directory from current folder. Like I don't have to give complete path, I'm using a relative path. From current directory we have a Yelahanka folder, I copy. So say ls, it will not be there. If you go to cd Yelahanka folder and you do ls, so you'll find the file there. If you want to, if you move the file in the same directory, file 1, if I say file 2, are the same file. Okay, so I have to change the name. So I can do like this. When I do a ls, it says it changes the name of the file, it renames the file. So mv can be used to rename the file whenever you change the move the file from same directory to from one directory to the same directory, the name of the file is changed. You can rename the file. If you use a different, for example, you have file 2 now. So if you use ./, okay, you can use ... to the previous directory. So now ls, there is no file here. Cd ... we go one directory up and we do ls, we can find that file 2 here. So this way we can use a relative path or anything to use. MV is used to move the file. If you want to copy the file, you can use a cp command. You can also copy the folder. So what happens if you copy the folder? You have to use cp -R to copy the complete folders. For example, I have file here. I'll move this file to Yelahanka folder. So now if I want to copy the Yelahanka folder, if I say cp Yelahanka to /home/mac/asia/india/Delhi/Birla. If I want to copy this Yelahanka folder to Birla, so it says omitting directory. So whenever there are files inside the folder, you cannot copy like this. So what you have to do is you have to add a minus R option. So it will copy the entire files inside the Yelahanka directory. So now if you would say LL or LS, LL is nothing but LS minus AL. It's an alias. We'll see alias later. So if I check the, so you can see Yelahanka file is here. If I say Yahanka, it's in Birla. So you can copy the entire directory using minus R option with the copy. Or if you use a move option, you see now you can see ls/home/mac/asia/india/karnataka/bangalore. You can see the Yahanka folder here because we have just copied it. If you do a move here, so you can see if I say Control E, the cursor goes to last. Control A, the cursor comes to first. Then I can delete this and say MV, and I can move the complete Bangalore folder to /home/mac/asia. So if I say ls/home/mac/asia, you can see the Bangalore folder is been moved from there. And you cannot find in the Karnataka directory. So we can move the folder completely. So when we copy the folder, we have to use a minus R option to copy all the files inside the folder. So this way we can use move command and copy command. So if you do exit, it will exit out of the account. It will exit the terminal. So this way we can use a few basic commands in Linux. So we'll see more in the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching this video.